We are going live in 3 seconds, guys.
Sushil, what all does your company do? I think Basesh has muted us for a timing. We can chat later.
Hi guys, we are live. People can see and hear us on YouTube. So I'll request all our viewers, there are already some people waiting there, that we will start in some time. So kindly bear with us.
Hi guys, we are live.
So dear viewers, thank you for coming in big numbers. We will start in some time. We request your patience and cooperation. We will start very, very soon. Thank you so much. All our panelists and moderators are here. Thank you. Yes, dear viewers, thank you so much. We are about to start very, very soon. There are more than 50 people already waiting. We will start at around 5 p.m. We appreciate your patience. Thank you so much. Apologies, we'll start in some time, 4:30 p.m. We'll start in a couple of minutes. Thank you so much. Yes, Ilaben, we can start. Ilaben, please take over.
Am I audible?
Yes, yes.
Am I audible? Okay. So, Saurav, can we see you?
Hi, ma'am.
Saurav is here.
Yeah. Yes, I can see you.
Hi. Okay. Welcome to all of y'all to the interactive webinar on education and career, from clutter to clarity, transforming challenges to opportunities, which is hosted today by our own Shri KVO Sthanakwasi Jain Mahajan Sanchalit, Matushri Manibai Shivji Devji Kanya Keroni Fund, and along with supported by 39 Solutions. Thanks. Thank you, Bashesh. I welcome the panelists. I welcome Bashesh, who is the keynote speaker today. And I also welcome the rest of the panelists. I will be introducing each one also. But let me just introduce the panelists. Saurav Ghosh, Dr. Nitin Chheda. We can't see him. I think, just check.
Yes, I'll check. He's there.
Yeah. Sushil Mungekar. Hello. Shama Nabar. We have Dr. Nirmala Almeida. And Kailash Gajara. Welcome to each of you. It's a very special day today. During the pandemic, when people are, there are many people who are very upset about many things that are going on for many different reasons. Of course, the fundamental reason being health. There are so many other reasons that are associated to this particular situation. There are people who are struggling and supporting the ones who really require support in the health situation, the COVID-19. And we really begin this entire session thanking them, especially the doctors, the medical fraternity, who are working so hard while we are also doing this lockdown. Also at the same time, our own busy party leaders, the party men, the party people, who are also the different political parties I'm talking about, who are busy working behind, struggling hard to see that this entire situation comes in control, along with the medical fraternity. You also have people in the police force, the army, and the several other people who are supporting us to continue with our normal livelihood, our own life. They could be the smallest, the grocer down the lane. It could be the milk person, the one who comes to clear our dustbins. There are those people who are still at work, and possibly there are many who are fortunate, who are at least sitting healthy and safe in their own, whatever kind of house that they are in. But at least they have a shelter, they have a place where they can smile and they can live happily. So I think we will pray for those who are actually attacked by the viral, and we hope that they revive back to their healthy conditions soon. And we also wish that all the ones who are dedicated their life and they are very happy hours to getting them back spring to normal, we wish them also the very best. And here we have these, the KVO charitable organizations, each one trying hard to work in various different capacities. Some who have tried to give rehabilitation in the form of food, some who have given in the form of finance, some in medication, and many other things. So I think we would really like to congratulate all these NGOs who have tried to keep the spirit of the community up in this time, to say that you are not alone. We are all with you. You need anything, we are all with you. So we really would like to support this community and the community NGOs who are doing various different kind of work. Some of them are doing very creative work also, keeping the young children engaged, keeping the older people engaged, because this is a difficult time. And in this whole difficult time, I would like to thank all you panel members who have come out of your busy schedule. I'm saying busy schedule because I know that even in this lockdown period, each one of you are busy up, even up to the night of 12 p.m. Y'all are all up and doing some work or the other, keeping your businesses or your socially keeping people engaged. I know all of y'all are also busy with webinars and creating new creative products, preparing for the next season, I would say. So I would really like to thank all of y'all wholeheartedly for everything that you have been doing and that you continue to do. And the few minutes that you will spend over here with all of us and share, give a very interactive session and really move the people who attend this webinar, who are really interested in moving the clutter and get more clarity. And we are going to touch upon education and career as the chief motto of this organization. The chief motto of this organization is educational growth and educational advancement, career prospects and career prosperity for the students. So we are here mainly for the youth, and we will try to cater to them. But along with that, we may have certain connective issues to handle, which we will also be doing. And I would like all the panelists to share a few words of your wisdom pertaining to this particular topic. But before you start, I'm going to read a very, very short introduction for each one of you, because each of you mean a lot to all of us. And I want the audience to really know who are these panel members. I'm not going in any particular order. So I begin with Saurav. Saurav is a B.Tech in electronics and telecommunication. He has done a management program at the IIM Lucknow. He's a national silver medalist in table tennis. He's a co-founder of Sports Reconnect. He has been voted as the top 10 sports startup in India. He's also a faculty of the Art of Living since last 12 years, and he has trained more than 15,000 people. Congratulations, Saurav, and thank you very much for sharing your wisdom here. I would also like to introduce Bashesh, who has been not only the supporter of this program, but I will say that he is like an anchor whom we hook on in many different times, who has always come forward to support youth activities. Bashesh Gala is an international business mentor and leadership coach. He has more than 12 degrees in finance, strategy, and IT. I'm not going to read your bio data because he has not sent it to me. Although I reminded him several times, he said, "You can just give the number." He has mentored more than 200 companies during the lockdown period. Can you imagine that? I don't know whether he's made money out of it. I will ask you that too, Bashesh, because that's also very important for many people to know. So I would really like to congratulate Bashesh for the kind work that he has been doing and the kind of work that he has been otherwise doing of corporate mentoring. Thank you, Bashesh, for being here. Sushil Mungekar, he is a chemical engineer. I think there are too many engineers now. A chemical engineer, an MBA, and a corporate professional now turned into entrepreneurship and entrepreneurship education for school children with his new venture, Enpower. I call it new because he's had many stints in the corporate world. And thereafter, this is his new venture. Welcome, Sushil. Sushil has one more connect, which I like to mention. Sushil, if you don't mind, I would like to mention Dr. Mungekar, your father, who was the vice chancellor of the Mumbai University. So he comes with a very strong academic background. We now welcome Dr. Nirav Chheda. It's so nice to have a medical person here. Nirav, you can carry all our blessings and wishes to the entire medical fraternity. We pass it on through you over here. Nirav is an ENT surgeon. He has a practice of more than 15 years in Sion and Ghatkopar. His contribution to youth is his passion, which he is pursuing since last 20 years, which he started with the Kachi youth at Matunga. And he's also involved with many, many corporate organizations thereafter. Few years ago, he was also a faculty for Kutch Corporate Forums and the Know Your Business and many others. If you don't mind, Nirav, I will give one more introduction of yours. I love the work that his parents do, Dr. Hasumati Chheda and Dr. Dheeraj Chheda. They both work for charity a lot in the medical field. Both are medicos and they both have been contributing a lot in Kutch as well as in Mumbai. And we really have their blessings also along with us. I would now have the pleasure to welcome Shama Nabar. Shama is a master's in psychology, a PG diploma in counseling psychology. She works as a counseling consultant, a consultant counselor for St. Xavier's College, Mumbai. Also for our own Hirji Bhojraj and Sons, Matunga boarding students. So we are connected with her very closely. She also is connected to the St. Joseph's Home and Nursery. She has conducted several programs for the KVO community in various areas and for various centers. So we welcome you, Shama, to this program. We have Kailash Tulsi Gajara. Kailash, I will begin your introduction with your father, Tulsi Gajara, who is connected to the Kutch community through the Kutch, to the NGOs in Kutch. So we would like to welcome you. He is the founder and the CEO of Atulsia Technologies. It's a software company. And he's very passionate about art and artistic work, crafts work. And he's also here. One of the reasons is his support to artisans made in Make in India and Made in India. He runs a mega store, which is a e-commerce platform. He's of course a master's in computer science. He's got his education in the US from the USC. Just like Bashesh has his education in the US. We have Kailash also, who came back to India to contribute to India. And I think this is the right time. India requires youth and innovation through y'all. And we really thank you for your contribution to, in whatever way you can, to the community, to the society. And Kailash is not mentioned, but I can also say he also guides students for international education. And we have a small connect for that too. Last but not the least, I hope I've introduced everyone else. Last but not the least, we have Dr. Nirmala Almeida, who is a blend of a teacher, a researcher, a practitioner, a counselor, and a counselor trainer. She is, of course, a PhD in psychology from the University of Mumbai. She spent 38 years in the College of Home Science, Nirmala Niketan, a visiting faculty in the Social Work College of Nirmala Niketan, at St. Xavier's College, and many other colleges. She is associated to several other departments in the university too, of education and psychology. She has been a consultant counselor for St. Xavier as consultant psychologist to schools, colleges, to name a few, the prestigious St. Xavier's College. And our own, so we will a little about Nirmala, that she basically is a counselor for medical patients also. That's a hidden talent in her, the way she has handled patients, the way she handles marriage counseling, the way she handles teenage and youth issues and challenges, and many others. So I would really like to welcome Dr. Nirmala Almeida also for this program. You'll have to take out that pin on the video, Nirmala. Yeah. So I would like to welcome all the speakers, all the panelists, and I would like to now begin to request Bashesh to begin saying a few words.
थैंक यू सो मच. और मैं हिंदी में बोलूंगा बिकॉज काफी कमेंट्स में हमको रिक्वेस्ट आया कि यूज हिंदी यूज गुजराती. सो वी विल गो कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश. और कुछ पॉइंट्स बोलना चाहूंगा वेरी वेरी शॉर्ट. आई थिंक ये डेफिनेटली चैलेंजिंग टाइम्स है फॉर पेरेंट्स एंड फॉर चिल्ड्रन, बट इट इज अ ह्यूज ब्लेसिंग इन डिसगाइज एंड अपॉर्चुनिटीज. मैंने कुछ 5 पॉइंट्स लिखे बिकॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड नॉर्म्स अब टूट गए. एंड इफ यू वर्क हार्ड, इफ हमारे बच्चे हार्ड वर्क करते हैं, स्मार्ट वर्क करते हैं, तो एक बहुत बड़ा अपॉर्चुनिटी है वेर दे कैन अचीव अ लॉट ऑफ सक्सेस, अ लॉट ऑफ ग्रोथ इमीडिएटली. मैं आपको 3 केस स्टडीज देना चाहता हूँ वेर यंग यूथ बिटवीन द एज ऑफ 15 to 25 हैव डन अ लॉट ऑफ गुड वर्क. उन्होंने बहुत अच्छा काम किया है मार्च और अप्रैल महीने में. पहला है एक लड़का है जो पुणे बेस्ड है और उसने 85 lakh रुपीज कमाए. मनी इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट बट अपॉर्चुनिटी इम्पॉर्टेंट है. ही टीचेज एवरी वन इंस्टाग्राम मार्केटिंग. अब लॉकडाउन के दरमियान सब घर पे बैठे है तो वो इंस्टाग्राम सिखाता है. ही इज लॉन्च हिज कोर्स फॉर 999 में उसने कोर्स लॉन्च किया है एंड थाउजेंड्स ऑफ पीपल हैव एनरोल्ड हिज कोर्स. इनफैक्ट ही डज अ लॉट ऑफ इंटरव्यूज ऑफ सेलिब्रिटी ऑल्सो. तो एक लड़का जिसका कोई फैमिली बिजनेस बैकग्राउंड नहीं है, जिसका कोई एंटरप्रेन्योर स्किल्स नहीं है, बट ही इज अ हसलर और वो डिजिटल मार्केटिंग पे गया एंड ही इज एबल टू जनरेट गुड फैन फॉलोइंग, गुड रेवेन्यू. Second, I think there's a lot of example of people who are guiding each other. So digital ke through, hum log bahut make aur ek example dena chahunga ki there's a young girl who is guiding the entire world sitting on India in terms of using Ayurveda and yoga for spiritual balancing and for positivity. And she's earning a lot of fan following. YouTube pays her $100 every day ad revenue mein. Real life stories. So I have got many such examples. Mera kehne ka ek hi matlab hai ki yadi aapko career ya business हम हमारे बच्चे को प्लान कर रहे हैं, वी हैव टू चैलेंज द स्टेटस को कि जो हम हजारों लाखों करोड़ों रुपया एजुकेशन में डिग्रीज के पीछे डाल रहे हैं, शायद उसको रीथिंक करना है बिकॉज दिस इज अ बिग अपॉर्चुनिटी. और मैं 5 चीज रिकमेंड करता हूं. नंबर 1, दिस इज अ राइट टाइम टू लर्न. कितने सारे प्लेटफॉर्म्स में कितना सारा नॉलेज है. सुशील जी हु इज वन ऑफ आवर पैनलिस्ट टुडे, ही टीचेस यंग किड्स आप कैसे अच्छे एंटरप्रेन्योर बने. सो वी देयर आर सो मेनी कोर्सेज ऑन डेटा एनालिटिक्स, ऑन इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, एक्सेल है, कम्युनिकेशन, डिजिटल मार्केटिंग, मेडिकल, लॉ. तो अभी डिग्रीज का इतना इंपॉर्टेंस नहीं है जितना एक्चुअल नॉलेज और स्किल्स का है. सेकेंड, प्लीज अपग्रेड. इवन मेरा रिक्वेस्ट रहेगा सभी पेरेंट्स को. एंड बिफोर दैट इलाबेन, कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन, वी हैव मोर देन 200 पीपल लाइव कनेक्टेड विद अस और वो नंबर बढ़ते जाएगा. तो आपके इनिशिएटिव ऑलवेज इज अ हिट. पीपल आर देयर एंड यू कैन आस्क अस ऑल क्वेश्चंस देयर. बट माय पॉइंट इज कि आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट कि पेरेंट्स ऑल्सो नाउ हैव अ माइंड सेट कि वो भी सीखे. दे हैव अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम, इंटरनेट पे सीखे, डिस्कवरी चैनल पे सीखे, स्टार्ट लर्निंग अबाउट न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी, डिजिटल मार्केटिंग. बिकॉज इफ यू विल लर्न इन दिस न्यू वर्ल्ड, ओनली देन यू विल अर्न. लर्न only then you will earn. So please keep this attitude of learning. Third, it is extremely important. Future of all kids is their circle. And I always keep saying this is in this, there's a big opportunity. Ki agar inka circle positive hai, circle mein aspirations hai, circle mein innovation hai, toh wo aspiration, wo innovation, wo learning circle aapke bachche ko push karega ki chalo main koi course karta ho, main fitness pe kaam karta ho, main koi book read karta ho, main online kuch content dalta ho. बट अगर आपका सर्कल यही है कि कौन सा सीरीज देख रहे हो नेटफ्लिक्स पे, क्या टाइम पास करते हैं, चलो गॉसिप करते हैं, चलो गेमिंग पबजी खेलते हैं, तो आपका किड वैसे ही इन्फ्लुएंस करेगा. सो माय रिक्वेस्ट इज पेरेंट्स, आप अपना सर्कल भी रीचेक करो और अपने किड्स का भी सर्कल चेक करो. इफ देयर सर्कल हैज अ लॉट ऑफ लर्निंग हंगर एंड इनोवेशन, इट इज ऑटोमेटिक ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन. एंड हसल, यू नीड टू स्टार्ट हसलिंग. लास्ट ईयर लॉकडाउन के पहले, लेकिन लास्ट ईयर एक 6 साल का बच्चा है, केंजी रियोटो. He is a 6-year-old kid and he earns 180 million US dollars. और वो टॉयज का रिव्यू करता है. सो स्पेशली अभी दुनिया जब डिजिटल हो रहा है, देर आर नो बैरियर्स. अगर आपके पास टैलेंट है, आप हसल कर सकते हो, आप हार्डवर्क स्मार्ट वर्क कर सकते हो, आप कम्युनिकेट कर सकते हो, देन यू कैन रीच एनी वन टूडे. देर इज नो कॉस्ट ऑन पुटिंग अ वीडियो ऑन यूट्यूब, देर इज नो कॉस्ट ऑन पुटिंग कंटेंट ऑन इंस्टाग्राम, देर इज नो कॉस्ट ऑन क्रिएटिंग गुड ईमेलर्स. तो जितना आप डिजिटल मार्केटिंग, हसल और लर्निंग करोगे, उतना काम होगा. एंड दोज हु वांट टू डू बिजनेस, द नेक्स्ट 12 मंथ्स इज अ गोल्डन टाइम. मेरे को काफी क्वेश्चंस आ रहे थे कि व्हाट इज द फ्यूचर ऑफ एजुकेशन. आई थिंक एजुकेशन में भी अब इनोवेशन डिस्ट्रप्शन आएगा कि पीपल शुड नॉट स्पेंड लैक्स एंड करोड़ ऑन एजुकेशन, बट दे शुड स्पेंड लैक्स एंड करोड़ ऑन स्किल डेवलपमेंट, ऑन एक्सपीरियंसेस, ऑन एक्चुअल लर्निंग. सो दिस इज अ ह्यूज अपॉर्चुनिटी. अगर आपको एजुकेशन एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप में जाना है, बिजनेस में जाना है, After 12 months, there's a huge opportunity. बहुत सुंदर opportunity है बहुत सारे field में, healthcare, data, IT, logistics, digital marketing, nutraceuticals, बहुत सारे field में, e-commerce. We have one more speaker, Kailash ji, जो e-commerce में light देंगे. There are lots of opportunities. And if you want to plan a job after studies, तो अभी आपको job के लिए you have to behave like an owner. You have to also behave like a salesman. You have to behave like a marketing person. You have to now start becoming an all-rounder. सिर्फ एक स्पेशलाइजेशन स्किल से इनफ नहीं होगा, आपको 2-3 स्किल सेट और ट्रेड्स मेंटेन करने पड़ेंगे. ओनली देन कंपनीज विल यू नो लुक टू हायर यू एंड ग्रूम यू एंड मेंटोर यू. इफ यू कैन गिव मच मोर देन व्हाट दे वांट इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिजिटल ब्रांडिंग, सेल्स, मार्केटिंग एफिशिएंसी, सो नाउ दिस इज द राइट टाइम टू बिल्ड योर माइंड सेट. एंड माई रिक्वेस्ट इज टू ऑल द 200+ व्यूअर्स सीइंग अस इज एज पेरेंट्स, एज किड्स, सिट विद योर फैमिली एंड स्टार्ट लर्निंग रेलेवेंट थिंग्स एंड अपडेट योर माइंड सेट. That we need to change with time, we need to work on skill development, and we need to start hustling. If you do that, there is a lot of opportunity for growing and success. So I end my short speech here. Over to the next speaker.
Okay. So can we hear a few words now from Saurav? Thank
sure,
you,
ma'am.
Vashish, for your inputs. We'll get back to you. Yes, Saurav.
So first of all, thank you so much, Dr. Ila ma'am, for introducing so wonderfully. And it's an honor to be among such privileged panelists. Also, Vashish sir, it's always an inspiration to listen to you. Thank you so much for all your inputs and all your help always. I would just like to start with a table tennis story from my own life of my first national tournament. So this was in Delhi. I was playing a national tournament. In the first round, I was playing against a guy from Delhi itself. And before I know it, the whole stadium was full and the whole stadium turned against me. So when I would lose a point, the whole stadium would erupt. It was very similar to what was happening as you had seen in the movie Chichore. And very shortly, I was down 3-0. And then suddenly one thought just stuck me. And it just stuck me that, can I just drop what other people are thinking about me? And can I just drop this outcome of this match? And can I just play one point at a time? The moment this thought came in my head and I started working towards it, one big shift happened. I started enjoying my playing time. Not just that, I managed to turn around that match. I managed to win it 4-3 and also happened to play my first ever national semifinal in that particular tournament. This very instance taught me two very important things. The first thing is, there is always a choice in life. Like, for example, like Basish sir rightly said, in this lockdown, we have a choice. Either we can crib and complain about the circumstance, or we can utilize this time productively to learn new skills or work towards our own physical and emotional development. The second thing is, when we go ahead to pursue our dream, there might be thousands of people who might come in between to deter us or to say why this will not happen. But it is our conviction in our belief and our persistence that really helps us to achieve our goals. Now, in this journey of achieving our goals and fulfilling our dreams, for me, I have learned certain hacks to ensure that we can move along this journey a lot more faster and in more productive way. So the hacks for me has been breathing techniques. I had learned this very interesting quote which said, "No breath, no life. But if you know breath, you actually know life." So when I started learning breathing techniques, then automatically what happened, my productivity started improving. I had learned this through the Art of Living programs in my 12th standard. The first experience was, I was an average student. The maximum expectation for me was around 80-85 in my 12th standard. But after practicing the techniques, my concentration improved so much that I managed to score around 97 in my PCM and 194 out of 200 in my CET. So there was a drastic shift in my performance in terms of concentration. The same performance level, thanks to the breathing techniques, also happened in my journey in sports. Whereas where I could never play without a coach, I started playing, understanding what the opponent would do, and I became a national level silver medalist. Why am I saying this? Is because breathing techniques can really help you to enhance your immunity at this time, can help you to improve your focus, and can help you to improve your concentration as well. And what better time than this lockdown to really learn something like this? The last thing that I would say is, often the physical goals that we pursue has been put on the back burner due to one simple reason of lack of time. But this time, because we have a lot of time, it's a fantastic time to ensure that we take out time to achieve our physical goals. So I would just like to end by saying this one interesting thing. Like in archery, you pull the string behind. And the more behind you pull the string, the more faster and the forward you go. Similarly, the more deeper you go within yourself, the better you are able to do it outside. And if you follow all of this, I'm sure your life will be more leading towards clarity from the clutter that we often face. Thank you very much. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, Saurav. Wonderful words. It's really brought in a lot of clarity, even for the physical well-being. And now we go to Dr. Neerav.
Hello, everyone. Thank you, Ilaji and Basish, for allowing me opportunity to join here. I've already started learning new things in just 10 minutes. So thank you. A great opportunity and a lot of attitude of very good. Let's understand that this attitude we all youngsters have, and as we have grown financially and mentally, we have done a lot of attitudes in life. But you need to get the attitude of gratitude. The moment you have that in your life, a lot of things are already settled for life. As Basish and Saurav were saying about knowledge and experience. So definitely the knowledge is one part. I think Google has everything now. So you Google it and you know it. But there is something called as experience, and that is what is going to matter in the lives to come. Everybody knows what is rasgulla, or everybody knows what is a pancake for the youngsters. if I try to explain you and I give you knowledge of pancake, it is very, very difficult. I will not be able to give you that exactly. But the moment you have one pancake, you know it all. Then I don't need to give you any knowledge about that. And the life to come is about that. There is called as circle of knowledge. All must be knowing, but if you not know, suppose you have entire knowledge in the world, in the, this five fingers. What you know is only this small part that I know that I know. There is very small part which is that I know that I don't know. Maybe these two fingers, two part of these fingers. But there is entire palm which says that I don't know, I don't know. Your life is there. I don't know, I don't know. I am a doctor, and then people, once they go to a doctor, they tell you that you do this check, you do that check, you do CBC, you do CT scan. So for me, this is the best time to do a self-check. You have all the time in the world, as he says, that the time, and this is the time for your lifetime, and it is for the lifetime. You'll remember this time. So this is a time to self-check. And nowadays, you are so lucky. Like we were, when we were growing up, we did not have so much of specialty, so much of people. And the test you have in medical field, similarly, you have so many specialists who can really help you, who can really help you understand, who can really help you what you are good at, what you can do, what are your likings. And there are so many things are available as a test. So utilize that. And as there is said, that there's always a balance between the heart and the brain. You need to have that balance in life, because there is a difference between a success and there's a difference between happiness. Because what you can have as a success, what the brain understands and what heart feels, is very, very different things. As the title, I love the title, Clutters to Clarity. I think this is the best time in your life where you can shed off a lot of unwanted baggages, clutters off, and move to clarity. And as again the title says, I hope that you all have transforming life and you create your challenges into opportunities. All the best to all of you. Take care. Love you.
Thank you so much, Nirav. Dr. Nirav, we respect you for your work and for your words, both. Off to Sushil. Can we have you, Sushil?
Yeah. Thank you, Ila ma'am. It's always wonderful to talk to you, and through this medium now we are talking. Thanks, my friend. We always call Basesh a powerhouse of energy, and all the panelists. Topic jo hai apna, it's on education and career. So main thoda education pe baat karunga, because my venture in last 4 years, Empower, jahan pe hum log bachcho ko entrepreneurship mindset sikhate hai. And pichle 4 startups mein jo maine kiya hai, ya usme jahan pe startups ko mentoring kiya, उसमें जो भी नॉलेज मिला वी ट्राई एंड गिव दैट बैक टू स्टूडेंट्स एट अर्ली एज. एजुकेशन पर्टिकुलरली, आई मीन इन द करंट ऑल ग्लूमी फेज, नेचुरल एजुकेशन एज इंडस्ट्री इज इंपैक्टेड. बट जस्ट एज वी सेइंग क्लटर टू क्लैरिटी, क्या क्या चीजें कर सकते हो, तो इसको मैं ब्रॉडली 4 डिफरेंट वेज में ब्रेक करना चाहता हूँ. पहला है फॉर्म, यू नो व्हाट फॉर्म ऑफ एजुकेशन. जैसे 17 मार्च के बाद स्कूल्स बंद हो गए, तो एक आयरनी हो गई. 17 मार्च पहले हम सारे पेरेंट्स और एजुकेटर्स मोबाइल फोन को बैन करते थे और कॉन्फिस्टिकेट करते थे मोबाइल, और 18 मार्च के बाद में बच्चों के हाथ में मोबाइल थमा दिया और बोला कि बच्चा पढ़ इसमें से. सो नाइदर द टीचर नॉर द स्कूल नॉर द पेरेंट एंड नॉर द स्टूडेंट, किसी को एग्जैक्टली आइडिया नहीं कि ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन होता है कैसे. वाइल ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन इज देयर इन इंडिया फॉर अ लॉन्ग, बट जस्ट द शिफ्टिंग फ्रॉम ऑफलाइन टू ऑनलाइन, यू नो दैट्स नॉट ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन. बच्चों को उसके साथ में कोप अप होना, टीचर्स को उसके साथ में कोप अप होना, और पेरेंट्स जो वर्क फ्रॉम होम एंड वर्क फॉर होम जो कर रहे हैं साथ में, उनको उसके साथ में कोप अप होना, दीज आर ऑल चैलेंजेस दैट वी नीड टू टेक. बट स्लोली नाउ वी आर सीइंग दैट ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन इज गोइंग टू बी अ सिग्निफिकेंट पार्ट ऑफ अ कंप्लीट एजुकेशन पैकेज दैट वी आर गोइंग टू गेट. वी कांट शाय अवे, वी हैव टू स्टार्ट प्रिपेयरिंग आवरसेल्फ. सो मैं बोलना चाहूंगा कि एज अ पेरेंट और एज अ टीचर और एज अ स्टूडेंट, you have to start preparing for online education. That's about the form. The second and the most important thing is substance. Everybody is talking about the form, moving from offline to online, but nobody is talking about the substance. Kya jo hum log jo sikha rahe abhi, math, science, history, geography and all, kya utna hi kafi hai bachcho ko future ke liye run karne ke liye? Ye COVID ne humko sikhaya hai ki uncertainty is the biggest thing. Nobody had predicted. And going forward, to deal with this uncertainty, we have to prepare our children. सो उनको लाइफ स्किल्स सिखाने पड़ेंगे. वी हैव टू टीच देम हाउ टू सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम्स, वी हैव टू टीच देम हाउ टू टेक डिसीजंस, वी हैव टू टीच देम हाउ टू थिंक क्रिएटिवली. जैसे बसेज भाई ने अभी बताया कि जो क्रिएटिवली ये पूरे चीज में सोचेगा, और उन्होंने कुछ एग्जाम्पल्स कोट किए कि जो क्रिएटिवली सोचेगा वो आगे निकल जाएगा, जो क्रिएटिवली नहीं सोचेगा वो डूम हो जाएगा, वो क्लटर में रहेगा, जो क्रिएटिवली सोचेगा वो क्लैरिटी में जाएगा. सो हाउ डू वी प्रिपेयर अवर चिल्ड्रन फॉर द फ्यूचर बाय टीचिंग देम लाइफ स्किल्स. एंड उसमें यू नो लास्ट चार साल से मैं यू नो टेरेस पे चिल्ला चिल्ला के बोल रहा हूँ कि एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप माइंडसेट, इट्स नॉट अबाउट स्टार्टिंग अ बिजनेस, इट इज फॉर एवरीथिंग. आपको अगर अच्छा डॉक्टर, लॉयर, इंजीनियर, रिटायरिस्ट, आर्टिस्ट, जो भी बनना है, यू नीड टू हैव एंटरप्रेन्योर माइंडसेट. The third important thing is responsibilities. As a parent, मैं बोलना चाहूंगा कि हमको parent को लगता है कि अच्छे school में बच्चे का दाखिला कर दिया, admission कर दिया, दो चार coaching classes लगा दिए, उसको uniform ले लिया, तो अपना काम खत्म हो गया. Then now it's school's responsibility. In the changing circumstances, that's not correct. As a parent, we'll have to now start taking lot of ownership of children's entire development. एंड इट्स बियॉन्ड क्लासरूम. क्लासरूम के बाहर जो बच्चा सीख रहा है, जैसे ऑनलाइन मेथड्स हो गए, या अगर लाइफ में जो भी लेसन आ रहे हैं, जैसे मैंने बताया प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग वगैरह, सो दैट इज समथिंग विच विल हैव टू प्रिपेयर एंड वी हैव टू ओन दैट रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. एंड आई विल बी हैप्पी इफ यू कैन गेट सम क्वेश्चंस ऑन दैट. एंड लास्ट वन मिनट आई विल टच अप ऑन द आउटकम. फॉर हेवन्स सेक नाउ लेट्स गेट आउट ऑफ दिस क्लचेस ऑफ मार्क्स, एग्जामिनेशंस, प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर दैट. बिकॉज कोविड के एग्जामिनेशन ने हमको सिखाया है कि क्वेश्चन पेपर इज सेट बाय समवन एल्स, नॉट बाय द एजुकेटर्स. तो वो लाइफ लाइफ का क्वेश्चन है, राइट? लाइफ के क्वेश्चन अगर सॉल्व करने हैं, करियर्स चेंज हो रहे हैं, जॉब्स चेंज हो रहे हैं. आज के जॉब्स है जो शायद 5 साल में रहेंगे नहीं, और 10 साल के बाद में जो जॉब्स होंगे हमको भी मालूम नहीं है. सो इन दिस एंटायर प्रोसेस अगर हमको तैयार करना है, तो वी हैव टू बी ओपन इन माइंड टू, आई मीन आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट कल से पढ़ाई बंद करो. व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज अलोंग विद दैट स्टार्ट प्रिपेयरिंग योर चिल्ड्रन for future skills, और वहां पे जाके they will be more successful, so that any challenge like COVID comes, they will shine with a great this thing. I'll be happy to take questions, and once again thank Ila ma'am, Basesh, and all the panelists for this wonderful opportunity. Over to you, Ila ma'am.
Yes, thank you so much. I think you have made very very relevant points, especially taking the pandemic as a very live example as to where we have to change. We'll get back to you also. In the meanwhile, can I ask Shama? Shama, for your few words. Shama, your voice is mute. Huh, yeah, now we can hear you.
This is okay?
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay, thank you, Ila ma'am. Thank you, Bashir sir. And hello friends, good afternoon. Today I am here to speak something on utilizing your time wisely during this time of the pandemic lockdown and choosing your careers wisely during this time. So what I would like to say is what we observe generally, and the calls that we get from the students, there is a huge uncertainty and confusion among students who have basically completed their 10th and 12th standard. Why? Because they are worried on the application part. They are worried on the admission part, because they want to, some of them want to stay in India, some of them want to go abroad, and they are really confused. What we as psychologists would say is just take one day at a time, be calm, be patient, because not only our country, but the whole world is facing this pandemic lockdown. So be patient about it. Now, I would like to speak something on utilizing this time wisely while making a career option choice. Now, your three things are very important while making a career choice. What are these three things? Just focus on these three things and you would be happily successful about your career choice. The first being your aptitude, that is your ability, your potential, or your skills that you're good at. Consider those options. The second is your personality trait. Everybody carries certain personality traits within us. Okay, nothing is good, nothing is bad. But a particular kind of personality is required for a particular kind of profession. Third thing is your interest. Why this interest is very important? Because interest keeps you motivated throughout. So interest is very important. Considering these three things, if you're uncertain, if you're not aware about your own weaknesses and strengths, what I would suggest is you can take the help of career guidance counselors, and some of them do online testings. So within this period, wherein you are stuck up with the pandemic lockdown, you can enroll yourself for this testing, get yourself tested, so that all the things are clear cut in front of you to make the choices. Secondly, if you are certain about which kind of profession you want to enter, there should always be plan A and plan B ready with you. Once this plan is ready with you, what you have to do is chalk out all the pros and the cons for each option that you have chosen. That is very important. Take the help of your parents, utilize all the technology available. See, there are educators around the globe who are ready to help everybody. They are grappling with the communicating with students using modern technologies. So take help. Okay, download brochures from various institutions. You can read more, read often. There are sample question papers or syllabus materials available in the market. If you have a particular profession in mind, please download those options, read about it. So you know, am I really interested in it going ahead? So use this time wisely. Second is, my request would be, humble request and sincere request would be, start using, setting your limits, like focus more on your logical thinking. For improving your logical thinking, or what we call in our language is your abstract reasoning, solve brain puzzles more. During this time, please download, there are so many puzzles, there are so many apps, completely free of cost. So download those puzzles and please start solving it. You will feel better and your capacity is improved. And lastly, I would end my statement positively, because always keep a positive attitude. The situation cannot be changed. It is not under our control. So what we can do is just be positive, because positive mental attitude can really turn mountains for you. Always keep that in mind. And thank you, everybody. Thank you, Ila ma'am. Thank you, the panelists, and all the my friends over here. Thank you so much. All the best.
Thank you, Shama, for your very soft and frank words.
Thank you.
And I would now like to welcome our last panelist, and that's Dr. Nirmala Almeida. Yanin.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can.
Okay. So it's a privilege to be here with everyone. My focus is on psychological well-being. So everyone knows that the pandemic has affected everybody, including the youth, in various areas. Emotionally, we find that the youth are anxious, they are angry, they are frustrated, they are sad, they are helpless. We also noted cognitively, many have reported to me that they are unable to focus on the task at hand. They are unable to think clearly. They are unable to recall facts properly. I've also noticed physically, as any doctor would say, they have complaints such as sleep disturbances, appetite problems, and somatic complaints. When you come to the social area, we find some of them are withdrawing, while some of them have become very aggressive. And I'm even venturing into the spiritual area, because I've found that many have lost hope, and they have a lack of meaning and purpose in their life. So now I would like to give you some points with respect to how the youth can cope with the situation. The first thing I'd like to say, which will surprise you, is that don't overestimate the dangers of this pandemic, and don't underestimate your capacity to protect yourself. The second point I would like to say, don't bombard yourself with information, especially fake news, rumors, misinformation. In fact, I would suggest that you youth should limit the number of times you are reading your updates, so as to reduce your worry and your agitation. I'd like you to change your perspective. I know staying indoors can be very frustrating and very annoying, but it's not awful. It's not terrible. It's not the end of the world. Seek support from people in your life, like your family members, your friends. And I think that will give you a sense of stability and some kind of comfort. I want you to validate your feelings, because your feelings are very normal. You may feel sad, you may feel frustrated, you may feel angry. That's fine. Acknowledge it, But then you need to move ahead and find out, what do I do to cope with it? Should I distract myself? Should I change my way of thinking? Strategy you can choose. Another point I would like to bring up is hold on to your stability rocks. What do I mean by a stability rock? A rock is something, a practice mainly, that will help to bring reliability in your life, which seems to be spinning out of control. But for each one, the stability rock is different. For some of us, stability rock may be a routine, structure. For others, the stability rock may be some relaxation or some listening to music or whatever. And now I'm moving on to how to transform this challenging experience of the COVID into a positive experience, into an opportunity for growth. So the first thing I would like to tell the youth is, think about your careers, visualize your careers. Now is the time to enhance your CV. Please enroll for some online courses. This is the time to hone your skills. This is the time to develop your talent. The second thing I would like to tell them is, do a lot of introspection, because you have the time now to do so. Start finding out, what are your strengths? What are your weaknesses? What are the external opportunities? What are the external threats? The SWOT analysis, as we call it. The third point is a very interesting point. I would like you to create a time capsule where you're going to document all the unique experiences of this pandemic so that you can revisit it several years later. So please go out into your balconies and take a photo of the empty street. You will never get this photo again in your life. And please keep some newspaper clippings, journal your thoughts and feelings. And as I said previously, you can revisit it later on, many years later, maybe after you're married and you have children as well. And you can say, we went through this experience called the pandemic experience. The fourth thing is that I would like to tell you to seek a reconnection, not only with family and friends, but with God. I don't know how many of you realize, but there is research to show that praying boosts the immunity system, reduces anxiety and depression, and increases hope and optimism. The fifth point I would like to bring up is, appreciate the good things that are happening around you. Are you aware, for the first time, the sky is so blue? There is no pollution. The animals have come out on the street in a very uninhibited way. Have you noticed that we're eating homemade, nourishing food? Have you realized we've become more caring and more compassionate? We have learned to be practical. We have learned to be economical. We have learned to be creative. And we have learned to differentiate between what we really miss and what we are really not missing. And the last point I would like to make is that we have been trained for crisis right from the time we were very, very young. Many of us have had a serious medical problem when we were young, and we survived. And then we went to school and some of us experienced failure and we survived. And then we grew older and we had a breakup in a relationship and we still survived. And many of us have lost a loved one and we have still survived. And we are going to survive this pandemic, but we have to trust our resilience. So I end up on this note, the pandemic is here to stay at least for some more time. But we can choose our reaction to the same. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Nirmala. Very, very encouraging words, very positive, too much of positivity. And I think that's what is really required amongst the youth and all of us also. So thank you, Dr. Nirmala. We have to hear from this young gentleman called Kailash Gajara. Kailash, can we have your words of wisdom?
ओके मैं भी बशेश भाई जैसे बताया है हिंदी कच्ची गुजराती आई जस्ट मिक्स ऑल ऑफ दिस आई जस्ट वांट टू मेक श्योर दैट एवरीबॉडी हु इज वाचिंग अस एकदम ऐसे नेटिव वैसे फीलिंग आना चाहिए कि हम सब साथ में हैं और इट्स एक तरह का रियान हेकड़ी रियान हलेती एडिते करीने यू हैव टू कंसीडर दिस सेशन ओपनली आस्क ऑल द क्वेश्चंस बशेश भाई इज आंसरिंग एवरीवन ऑन यूट्यूब तो मैंने कुछ ऐसे चेकलिस्ट जैसा नहीं बनाया बट आई विल जस्ट talk about, you know, few things that are helpful and limited to parents and students or young professionals. क्या क्या चीज करना चाहिए? तो first of all, for the students or young professionals, हमें goal setting करना अभी, you know, it's a good time that we can try to set our goals. And, you know, as ma'am abhi inhone bataya, journaling karna. Journaling is one of the very beautiful thing that you can do. And think about, like, you know, life goals. Ki mujhe kya karna hai. To kya karna hai, wo dimag mein hai. Lekin dimag se wo paper pe aana chahiye. Narendra Modi ka ek juna interview Akshay Kumar ke saath tha, if you have seen it. Bolte, aapko gussa aata hai, to kya karte hain? Akshay Kumar ne pucha. To Narendra Modi says, main ek kagaj pe likh deta hoon, aur usko faad deta hoon. Yeah, something. Now, one of the thing is, जब हम पेपर पे लिखते हैं things are in front of our eyes, तो वो actual में reality होने का chances ज्यादा है. So goal setting करना, various habits that we can, you know, start, you know, doing it. जैसे habits बनने के लिए भी उसको समय लगेगा, तो let's be disciplined during this time. Reading books करना, meditation, you know, try करना, very very simple things, like 5-10 minutes का ये करना. And positive thoughts रखना. So basically thoughts provokes action, सबको पता है. And basically अगर negativity around रहेगा, in last 5-6 years or so, मैं अगर बोलूँगा तो television time for me is like very minimum. पूरे दिन में भी maximum 5-10 minute अगर मैंने TV देखा तो वो. So negative news is lot of reading on WhatsApp. ये सब नहीं करना है. Think about the positive stuff. क्या research चल रहा है? अलग-अलग countries ये pandemic को किस तरह से टैकल करें, कीप इट टू द मिनिमम एंड बेसिकली पॉजिटिव थॉट रखना है हमेशा. सो यू हैव टू बी एन ऑप्टिमिस्टिक पर्सन ऑल द टाइम. कि कोई बोले यहाँ ये पॉसिबल है ही नहीं, नहीं पॉसिबल है ना, ट्राई करते हैं क्या हो जाएगा. तो इस तरह का पॉजिटिव माइंडसेट हम रखें. और जो नेटफ्लिक्स का पॉइंट आया, तो डेफिनेटली जो सर्कल है विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, जो बसेश भाई का पॉइंट था, कीपिंग अ गुड सर्कल फॉर स्टूडेंट्स इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. बट एट द सेम टाइम बहुत जन का पिक्टोरियल मेमोरी भी रहता है, राइट? सो इफ यू हैव दैट काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग, और मूवीज से ज्यादा याद रहता है, तो देयर आर हंड्रेड्स ऑफ गुड डॉक्यूमेंट्री मूवीज दैट यू कैन वॉच, और उससे बहुत सारा सीखने को भी मिलता है. आई हैव लिस्ट ऑफ लाइक 50 प्लस मूवीज. व्हेनेवर आई गेट सम रिलैक्स टाइम, मैं एक अच्छा सा मूवी देख लेता हूँ 2 घंटे का, जिसमें समवन हैज डन समथिंग, उसके रियल लाइफ पे हो गया, तो इट गिव्स अ गुड कॉन्फिडेंस. और ये है कि मोटिवेशन इज अ डेली थिंग, ये सबको समझना है. ऐसा नहीं कि हाँ मैंने रंग दे बसंती देख के आया, या फिर ये मूवी देख के आया, तो उसका जो नशा है वो 2-3 दिन तक रहता है, फिर वो शांत हो जाता है. सो मोटिवेशन हर एक दिन इंसान को डेली मोटिवेशन चाहिए. सो इट्स समथिंग दैट यू हैव टू गेट योरसेल्फ, यू नो, पम्प्ड अप एवरी सिंगल डे. जो करियर रिलेटेड और कुछ जो करियर गाइडेंस रिलेटेड है, नाउ इज द बेस्ट टाइम दैट पीपल आर यूजिंग दिस वेबिनार कॉन्सेप्ट ऑनलाइन, यू नो, स्काइप पे, यू नो, व्हाट्सएप पे, दे आर डूइंग लॉट ऑफ मीटिंग्स. And one of the things that I am personally working with some of the Samaj Karyakarta is that we used to organize career guidance seminar. Even in our Kavyo Samaj, we have a lot of seminars for, you know, abroad education and all that. So, abhi ye virtual career guidance kaise kare? What is this virtual seminar? To us pe hum kaam kar rahe hain. So, things will be, jaise hi kuch update aata, I'll be sharing that with Ila Madam. So, it is more like same virtual seminar. You will have, you know, different topics that you can click on. Enter the room inside and the real person, like हमारे साथ में 6-7 जन हम साथ में बात कर रहे हैं, ऐसा real person 1-to-1 आपके साथ कैसे guide करेंगे. So ऐसा पूरा virtual career guidance seminar पे काम कर रहे हैं. We will provide more update to the entire team. About parents, basically quickly, and you know, those who are into jobs, जो और businesses, एक चीज मैं कल ही बोल रहा था one of my real estate agent friend, that भाई आप ए रियल एस्टेट एजेंट ठीक है, बट यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड के वन टाइप ऑफ जॉब्स आर गोइंग टू गेट कन्वर्टेड टू द न्यू टाइप ऑफ जॉब. ऐसा दिमाग में रखना है कि कुछ तरह के जॉब्स आगे जाके नहीं रहेंगे, 10 साल में वो जॉब रहेंगे ही नहीं. यू हैव टू थिंक अबाउट इट, बीट द यूज ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस, टेक्नोलॉजी, और काइंड ऑफ, यू नो, पेंडेमिक ने जो सिचुएशन क्रिएट कर दिया, यू हैव टू बी रेडी. तो मैंने उसको, प्रदीप को बोला कि भाई आप एजेंट करते हो अभी, तो क्या कर रहे? कल ही बात किया उनसे, तो मैंने उनको वो टाइम पे बताया था कि कम अप विद अ सेकेंडरी लाइन ऑफ बिजनेस आल्सो एट द सेम टाइम. मैंने धीरूभाई अपना अंबानी का एग्जांपल दिया कि ही इज इनटू पेट्रोकेमिकल्स. उसको पता था कि आगे जाके ये डिजिटली टेलीकॉम में इतना सारा लोग ऑनलाइन आने वाला है, एंड 20-25 हजार करोड़, उससे भी ज्यादा मेरे ख्याल से जो भी इनका जो डेट रहेगा, वो करके भी उन्होंने जियो क्रिएट किया, पेट्रोकेमिकल्स के साथ में जियो. तो इफ द पेट्रोकेमिकल गोज ऑन, Jio is now up and Facebook has invested 45,000 crore at 10%. So basically, hamesha always think about like secondary line of business. Come up with new ideas constantly. Evolve karte rehna. One type of aapka business rahega. Think about something else also. Same cheez continue karte rehna. Uske saath saath mein kuch innovation leke aaye. To wo bahut zaruri hai. And at the same time, overall finance. Aapka finance manage karna. Think about not just 6 months. Think about 5 years from now, financial planning karna bahut zaruri hai for parents and everyone. How much am I supposed to invest for my kids' studies? What all different things we will need? Inflation ka ye sab karke thoda pen and paper leke financial cheezon pe thoda focus karna chahiye and be positive about it and plan it well. Jaise aap plan karenge, to ye ho sakega. And the last part that I'll mention about the social responsibility. Social responsibility is that first. Your thoughts, your mindset, your positivity, ekdam clear rahega. You are very clear. Now what you can do is you can inspire your family members. Are sab barobar ho jayega, ye sab band karo, hum chalo kuch aur karte hain. Something. Make your family also on the same page. You is now better. Family is also good. Fir bahar aana hai samaj. Samaj ke liye bhi kuch karna hai. To samaj ke jo alag alag initiative hai. This is one of the initiative. So usme aap leadership le sakte hai. You can say, Ila ma'am, I can do this, Ila ma'am, I can do, anybody, right? So now you, your family, now samaj, samaj ke liye bhi karna hai. Once you achieve good thing in samaj, next is nation, Bharat. Bharat ke liye bhi bahut sara cheez karna hai and then you can do it. Be it like with your innovative ideas or any organization that you join, non-profit, any activity. So we have to think of all these four things, not just me, not just my family, family and everything settled. We have a samaj also and we have Bharat also. So that is something that we have to do. And leadership ka ek simple definition I would like to tell for all students and young professionals. Leadership ka simple meaning, one line, simple, two words, is taking responsibility. There is nothing else. You can be from any background, you have money, no money, nothing. It doesn't matter. Leadership is someone who say, okay, I can do it. Okay, I'll try. Taking responsibility is something that we must all start doing. And that will actually, change various things for good for everybody. So, yeah, social responsibility related, I just wanted to share with you.
Thank you very much, Kailash. So before we proceed further, I will like to take this opportunity to thank once again the trustees and the entire managing committee members of Matushri Manibhai Shivji Devji Kanya Kedoni Fund, which is under the aegis of the SKVO Sanakwasi Jain Mahajan. And I would like to also thank 39 Solutions for its support. And we will continue the session. I would just like to add a few points to what has already been added. As an educationist, I would say that the students' anxieties has no limits, has no boundaries. The students who have been in the middle of exams and whose exams had to be discontinued, say one paper, four paper, three papers were left. They were in the verge of, they have studied, they are prepared to showcase their talents. They are prepared to showcase what they know, their knowledge. But because of the pandemic and because of the safety of the human being, there had to be, schools and colleges had to shut down much earlier. Almost on the 16th of March, schools had shut down. And by 17th, even the colleges had shut down. Those students, right from the 10th, the 12th, the first year, second year, third year, fourth year, and the postgrad students, are really in a big state of worry. There is no doubt about it. Because they have been able to accomplish some part of it and not been able to accomplish some other part of it. Then they were in the middle of something. We would like to give a message to all of them that one thing that you have to remember is that the Maharashtra State Board, the National Educational Board, whether it's the state 10th and 12th exam or the CBSE, ICSE exams, or whether they are the global IB exams of the 10th. Similarly, the university, all the various universities across the country and the UGC, the University Grants Commission, the RUSA, everyone is concerned about the only one person, and that is the student body. Students are basically the center of every decision. And because India has got diversity as far as economy, as far as technology, as far as infrastructure availability, as far as resources, there is so much of divide that it is going to take a while to come to some common decision. The UGC has come out with some circulars yesterday, and those circulars may keep changing, may keep upgrading. As we said, clutter is going to reach to clarity. The pandemic is something out of control. It was out of control of every human being. And therefore, one must not worry, when is my exam going to be? Let the people who have to worry about it worry, take that worry. And as all our panelists have given the rich source of, you can say, guidance, the guidance that they have given mainly is that you can collect your skills, the skills which you would have otherwise not got the time to do. You can sit and write your CV, upgrade your CV. A very good suggestion that was also given was that this is a time where you can write down your vision, your mission for yourself, your career path. Who had this time otherwise? We never got this kind of time where we could sit with our family members and really think of a path, work out a path. I think this is the right time. Hone your communication skills, hone your writing skills. There is always a scope for improving, even for me. Same is for you. We can all improve better our communication skills, our language skills. We can always add more language skills, new languages to our kitty. And as very rightly said by most of the panelists, the technological skills. Future is going to change. Sushil has just mentioned. The jobs are not going to be the same. Kailash did mention. The kind of businesses will not be the same. Bashish mentioned. Things are going to change. The core subjects will not change, but the way it is going to be done is going to be changed. And this is not only for this pandemic. Pandemic will occur and reoccur again. Maybe we'll find the vaccine. Maybe we'll find the cure for it. But at the same time, there could be another virus that can also come in. Let's be prepared. Let's not have a cluttered future. Let's take from clutter to clarity. And what is very important is what each panel member has said. I think we need to also ask questions. Research skills have to also change. Every youth over here is responsible for bringing about some positivity, bringing about some change in the life of the human being around us. We may stay home, but from within the homes, we can do so much. We can support and help our own families. Feel happy about it. It's not a waste of time. Supporting our own family members is not a waste of time. That itself is a huge social cause that you're reaching out to. There could be elders in the family. There could be very small kids. There could be youth or middle-aged people who are worried about their finances or their businesses. Sit with them. Talk with them. Try to see how you can help sitting at home. Use your social media. Use your technological skills. Find out what kind of researches you can do. I think research skills are also very important. It may help you and lead you to a new business. I would like to quote a very youth, a student of law. I have not taken his permission, but I'm going to quote him today. And that's Parth. Parth is working day and night. He's also going to come in as a speaker. A young law student who's having his own startup on financial literacy to the rural and the suburban parts of India. He's working on his own startup, on his own social cause. There is so much to do in this time. How can people say that we don't know what to do? There is enough. I don't think we have a single reason to grumble unless we are the attacks of the pandemic. Then we have to take care of our health. But otherwise, I think we have lots. And the panel members have stressed on life skills. And a very important point that Kailash stressed are the voluntary services. I think this discipline must come into every youth. Because giving voluntary services, social responsibility, is a very big responsibility. Why do we have to wait for people to do something for us? Why can't we do something for the society? It could be your own local area. It could be your community. It could be the district, state, or the nation, or it could be international. It could be that too. We have a young student of the same trust who was awarded a degree. Who was awarded a medal for her achievements in her degree, her graduation, medical degree. She is in touch with the pandemic patient, the corona patients. And it is a joy and a pride for us to see how she's serving the nation as an intern. This is the kind of service and this is the kind of leadership. This is the kind of passion that is expected from the youth. If there is nothing, one can always enroll for so many online courses. Saurav mentioned about health. I think he's touched upon a very important aspect. Nirmala touched upon spirituality. I agree. Whichever be your caste or creed, you can reach out your own self through your own religion. Every religion has an answer to the worries that worry you and do not give you sleep. It is also the various other points that have been touched upon by the various panel members. I would also now recommend and suggest Bashesh to take over further for a few points. We will again give the second round to all the panel members to add on their points that they would have missed out, to answer how, my common question to all is, how have you been able to work out during this pandemic period? How have you been able to support the society, yourself, your business? And what are your plans for the future if that can motivate the youth? Bashesh, to you.
Sure. And Dr. Dedia, we have a lot of questions pending on YouTube. So we will take that. So very briefly, I think, you know, this is a good opportunity. But I completely admire what Kailash ji has said that, you know, if you, you should have that bhavana of giving. अगर आप वो भावना रखते हैं कि मैं लोगों को हेल्प करूंगा, यू नो यू विल शाइन आउट. लाइक लीडर इज गिविंग क्लैरिटी, गिविंग एनर्जी, गिविंग विजन एंड हेल्पिंग अदर्स. सो इन बिजनेस बाय गॉड्स ग्रेस दिस अप्रैल वी हैव डन मोर बिजनेस देन व्हाट वी हैड डन लास्ट ईयर. बट दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ यू नो आवर एबिलिटी टू कनेक्ट टू पीपल, टू गाइड देम. एंड मनी इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, इट इज अबाउट एन अपॉर्चुनिटी. एवरी चैलेंज हैज एन अपॉर्चुनिटी. आई वुड जस्ट लाइक टू से थ्री थिंग्स विच इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. One is my personal belief that spirituality is a very, very powerful tool. And we should go back to our roots. Hum jitna spiritual ko appreciate karenge, utna hum life enjoy karenge. And no matter what your belief system, the word aparigraha, it is such a powerful word which means simplicity and sacrifice. And those who can live with that principle right now will be a very, very happy and content person. And second is anekantavad. Anekantavad means everyone has their own perspectives and everyone is right. I like what I think and I respect everyone's perspective. If you imbibe these two principles, you will be very happy and content in life, and then you'll start being able to have that mindset. Second, very, very quick thing is beautiful opportunity to build a lot of powerful habits and discipline. 40 days of lockdowns, if you do every day something powerful in terms of fitness, reading, learning, it becomes a habit. So that's a very, very powerful thing. And last, I think, is all members of the family, including our kids, I think this is the right time to do BJP. BJP is Bartan, Jadu and Pota. Contribute as a whole, you know, contribute in your home, be very, very grounded. And by doing that, you know, you go back to your roots, you learn simplicity and you enjoy life more. So that's my tip. The moment you help others, universe will help you back. Imbibe spirituality and build powerful habits. That is my mantra for now. Over to another speaker, please. And I will request very, very quickly, Dr. Dedi, I'll just continue passing it on.
Yeah.
Yeah. Saurabhji, please.
Sure. Thank you so much, Basish. And I think what you just mentioned is a beautiful summarization of a lot of things that we already mentioned. I would just like to just add on to this. Point number one being, when the going gets tough, the tough gets going. So this is a fantastic time to also innovate. Like for example, you might ask me a question that how does one play sports in this time? The answer to this is you might not have the necessary infrastructure to play that particular sport, but you can definitely upgrade your skills with respect to fitness or particular skill sets in that particular sport. For example, let's say I am a table tennis player and I do not have a table tennis table in my house. How do I improve my table tennis skills? What you can simply do is you can hang a table tennis ball from a thread. And you can just keep practicing, just hitting so that it goes and comes back in the form of a pendulum. Wow. This will help you to increase your hand-eye and your fine motor skills. Similarly, you will find innovative ways of learning different skill sets as when you are pushed to the wall. The second thing that so Shrili, you have some points to share?
No, go ahead.
The second thing I want to focus on, especially in the field of life in general, is this is a fantastic time to reconnect. There have been so many friends who we have been never had a chance to maybe that connect back, whom we were great friends in college. This is a great time to build meaningful connections back. Why don't we just reach out to 10 friends today and just ask them how they are? The last thing I would like to say on this is very similar, is everybody gets a greater joy in giving. There is a much, much more higher joy that each person feels when you are able to contribute to some person's life. So don't miss a single opportunity to contribute to other people. It can be as simple as just calling up a friend and just praising them, or it can be just donating to some daily wage worker. It can be any small thing. But moment you start doing that, I assure you, the other person will feel great, but even more happier than them, you will feel yourself. That much from my end. Over to the next speaker.
I'll talk about Sushil here.
Yeah.
Ila ma'am asked us a question, ki aapne kya kiya ye pure isme. So, you know, our business was with schools. We were dealing with school children. Summer workshops band ho gaye. So virtually the business was, we don't know what to happen. But during this time, we spread ourselves. We tied up with a global leader, which is into teaching game-based life skills, online game-based. You know, the company name is Axelium. It's an Israeli company. And they work in 30 countries with more than 5 million students over last 23 years. So we are now bringing them to India, their products and all. So yahi point jo Basit bata raha tha ki if you again change, you are agile, you can make changes and think differently. You can come back and solve your problems. And now we have already rolled out to some of the schools. एक पॉइंट मैं सौरभ से आगे लेना चाहूंगा. मीन ही स्पोक अबाउट यू नो कनेक्टिंग टू पीपल. अभी हम लोग बोल रहे हैं कि सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग है, वी कांट एक्चुअली टॉक टू पीपल एंड ऑल. व्हाई डोंट वी एज अ फैमिली सिट टुगेदर एंड मेक अवर सोशल कैपिटल चार्ट. और सोशल कैपिटल चार्ट होता कैसे कि आप जितने भी लोगों को जानते हो, आपके यू नो जैसे बच्चा है 12-15 साल का, तो हिज मम्मी पापा, पापा के सारे फ्रेंड्स, मम्मी के सारे फ्रेंड्स, उसके स्कूल फ्रेंड्स के मम्मी डैडी, उसके बिल्डिंग फ्रेंड्स के मम्मी डैडी, इनका सबका नाम एक चार्ट पे लिखोगे, चार्ट 20 40 50 60 80 नाम हो जाएंगे. इसके नीचे सारे लोगों के प्रोफेशंस लिखते जाओ, वो करते क्या है, कोई फैशन डिजाइनर है, कोई टेक्नोलॉजी है, कोई आर्टिस्ट है, कोई ब्लॉगर है, सारे लिखते जाओ. अपने मम्मी डैडी की हेल्प लो, ये चार्ट जितना बड़ा बना सकते बढ़ाओ. कीप अ फर्स्ट टारगेट ऑफ गेटिंग 100 नेम्स ऑन द पेपर और उसके नीचे पूरे लिखते जाओ. स्लोली यू विल गेट इन योर नेटवर्क. अगर आपको कहीं भी हेल्प चाहिए, जैसे आपको सिंपल वेबसाइट बनानी है, आप मम्मी डैडी को पूछोगे तो उनके पास में आंसर नहीं होगा, बट यू एग्जैक्टली नो आई हैव अ फ्रेंड अक्षय, इसका नाम है, इसके पापा वेबसाइट बिल्ड करते हैं, उसको अगर फोन उठा के आप बात करोगे तो 99.9% आपको फ्री एडवाइस मिलेगा और ऑथेंटिक एडवाइस मिलेगा. ये जो सोशल कैपिटल है, ये बिल्ड करना सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट है. लोग बोलते हैं कि बिजनेस चालू करने के लिए, वेंचर चालू करने के लिए पैसा चाहिए. रिसर्च शोज कि अगर आपका सोशल कैपिटल स्ट्रांग है तो आपको इनिशियल जो सीड कैपिटल लगता है वो 40-60% कमा सकता है अगर आपका सोशल नेटवर्किंग स्किल्स अच्छा हो. सो व्हाई डोंट वी यूज दिस टाइम टू बिल्ड दिस एंटायर सोशल कैपिटल ऑफ 100-150 पीपल दैट आई नो एंड उसके हर एक का एक नेटवर्क बनाओ एंड देन स्लोली यू विल गेट अ कंप्लीट लिंकेज. ट्राई एंड डू दैट. आपको ये लॉकडाउन कब खत्म होगा पता भी नहीं चलेगा.
थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू. कैन वी हैव अनदर पैनल मेंबर हु वुड लाइक टू शेयर? वेरी गुड आइडिया सुशील.
Hello.
Yeah.
I would like to share some things here. I always wanted to do something creative, but never had that time in hand because from Monday till Sunday, it used to be packed and counseling. So I tried my hands on painting, embroidery. So I was very happy doing that. And every day I have shared my numbers with most of the senior citizens of my area. So I'm available 24/7 for them. Because most of these senior citizens, their issue is their kids are staying abroad and most of them are staying alone at home. So providing some kind of either lunch or dinner to them gives me a lot of pleasure. So I have started with that. Secondly, what I have started with is feeding the street dogs in my area, feeding the crows, keeping water every day. feeding the dogs, and that gives me a lot of pleasure. So I'm working, even the students, for my students, I'm available 24/7, and I get a call, and whenever they call me, I am available. So whatever I'm doing, I keep that aside and I attend to those calls because they need our help a lot. So it's that.
Thank you so much.
Yes, thank you, Ila ma'am.
Neerav, Dr. Neerav.
As far as I am concerned, I'm not going to talk about medical thing what I'm doing. As far as the parents and child are concerned, I'll share that as a parent. The first thing I realize is this is the best time to learn because as it is said that what you preach is not important, what you do is important. When you tell your child that you have to keep a mobile down, and when you are on a Netflix or you are on some series, or when you start playing some games on a computer, and then your child tells you, Papa, taro time bhi upload thai gyo. And in that area, you have to control yourself, then you have to explain your children. That is what is really, really important. That you talk, not important. What you do is very important. So I am learning a different way of parenting now. That is number one. Number two is the way I have connected with my friends, the way I have talking with people, the way I am learning new technologies. As a doctor, I hardly used to be at home, so I really did not have time. I have all the time. I go to clinic sometimes for emergency, but otherwise the time which I have, I am really utilizing to connect with people. As people say that you have a list, but I am really connecting and talking with my friends. I have created group and we are playing particular time, not run on a group. That is what I love. So I have started doing my hobbies and I pursue that. Apart from that, I am playing cricket with my kids. I am doing a lot of drawing activity with my younger child. And what is another important thing is the way we as a family are living. And as Bashesh says at BJP, I do the J part of it. And a lot of other things which are opening up as a family member. And what I realize is, forget about what is important in life. I am experiencing life itself in a very, very different way. And connecting it spiritually, it's a fantastic journey. And I think we all will learn a lot of things out of this. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bashesh. Thank you, Neerav. We could see that sense of satisfaction on your face while you were talking. I think, Bashesh, the BJP is working for everyone.
Yeah, it is working. That's an experience. Yeah, only, experience only will help. If you talk knowledge, it will not help. If you have eaten pancake, you are happy.
Yeah. Yeah. The next panelist, Kailash, I think you had to say something.
So one thing is we can start, taking questions that are coming, but maybe
I would like to ask you a question.
Oh, sure. Okay.
I would like you to say a little about Megastore, how you have been able to help the artisans, and how do you think the youth can be involved in this whole scenario?
Yeah, definitely. So basically, megastores.com is a marketplace for handmade products. So any product that is there on Megastores is authentic handmade. And what we've been able to do is we are reaching out to various artisans, all over India, primarily four states, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Rajasthan, and Uttarakhand so far. So, women, karigars, a lot of artisans who are working in, the handmade art. We have in itself, in Kutch, there are more than 35 crafts. So these people, they are able to upload or sell their products directly on the platform without any middleman. So basically, customers can directly buy product from these artisans. And these days, because of lockdown and everything, of course, our logistic deliveries are paused. But fortunately, the customers, they are very much happy about the products and they know what these artisans are doing. And for every product, we are actually displaying artisan story. Like, who is this person? Ye kisne banaya hai? Kab se bana rahe ho? To uska pura interview and everything is available on every product. So customer knows that ye product Kutch mein, Rapper gaam mein, yahan pe isne banaya hai, ye Tangalia mein kaam karta hai, ye bandhani banata hai, ye ajrak banata hai, acha ajrak aise banta hai. So they know that they will not get product for a month or two or don't know, but they are still placing orders because karigars, they need cash flow right now because they'll not be able to sell things. जो exhibition से वो लोग sell कर रहे थे अभी तक various exhibition they used to attend even Bombay में भी we have very good exhibitions तो यहाँ पे उनके हैंडीक्राफ्ट प्रोडक्ट बिकते थे, दे यूज्ड टू यू नो अर्न मनी, बट एज ऑफ नाउ बिकॉज ऑल द ट्रेड इज गॉन, सो वी आर एनकरेजिंग राइट नाउ ऑल द कस्टमर्स टू प्लेस ऑर्डर right now and you know receive product after a month or two. So you know many people are you know cooperating and they are you know just giving best luck to all the karigars. And we have had a meeting, like a virtual meeting, Zoom meeting, all the karigars from Kutch area. I think 20 plus karigars they had joined and they were very happy. I mean Gujarati ma apde shanti che vando nathi haji chalse ek mahina to, you know, they are so much, they are giving energy back to us, so then we are more empowered. We are like, okay, हमें काम करिए पाचा. सो वी अगेन गो बैक टू द डिजिटल मार्केटिंग फ्रंट. एंड इनफैक्ट इन लास्ट, आई मीन टेक्निकली एंड मार्केटियर्स विल आल्सो अग्री, लास्ट 45 डेज कस्टमर एक्विजिशन कॉस्ट हैज बीन गॉन डाउन एंड द एंगेजमेंट ऑफ पीपल ऑन सोशल मीडिया हैज बीन इंक्रीज्ड 10x. बेसिकली पीपल आर रिप्लाइंग, दे आर यू नो पुटिंग कॉमेंट्स, लाइकिंग थिंग्स एंड ऑल दैट. सो वी आर फोकस्ड राइट नाउ ऑन द मार्केटिंग साइड ऑफ इट. वी मार्केट artisans, their stories, new products, various podcasts that we do. So yeah, that's what on the mega stores end. What we're trying to do is make in India, so, handmade in India is something that we are trying to promote.
Thank you, Kailash. What I really wanted to stress was what Sushil, what Bashesh gave examples, what Kailash said, that the world has not stopped. Businesses are not going to stop. Jobs are not going to stop. It's just that there is going to be a change in the style of our working. We will have to get more disciplined. We will have to upscale our skills, which is most important. And if students are really worried about exams, I would really like to say that we don't have the bandwidth to conduct online exams as a country, as a nation, which in the West has happened more than a decade before. So they have all the learning platforms on which the student can log in and appear for an online exam. Whereas here in India, maybe we do have online courses, we do have online assessment, but that is with a few platforms, which is not available for everyone. So it is going to take its time. Be rest assured, there is no exam in May that can happen. It is certainly not going to happen. You have an entire month to utilize for all your online courses and all the suggestions that were given to so many by so many panelists, to all the participants today. What I would also like to add is that the UGC circular, they had appointed two committees, of which one of the important suggestions that has come is that the next semester, the new academic year may start only by September. Now, if it is going to start by September only, that means the year end, that means the exams, the evaluation, even the 10th and 12th standard board exams are locked up in colleges. Nobody has been able to go and touch them also. So all the evaluation and examinations will not happen till the month of June. They will naturally happen later. So instead of just waiting for the colleges to open, for the schools to open, for the exams to be conducted, I would really suggest that don't keep waiting. It will all happen. I'm reassuring that at the government level, at the institute level, at the college and the school level, at the management level, at the academic level, there are people who are taking your responsibility, who are worried about you, who will give you enough time for examination as well as for admission. Right now, it is your time. You have to sit together right now with your family and plan your future for the next month at least. Do what you like to. If you don't want to do a course, it's fine. If you do an online course, also it's fine. If you don't do it, also it's fine, but do something. As Bashesh spoke, if nothing, then do your bartan jaru pota. At least that would help your moms. Do that much. It's real. It'll be very rewarding. Help your neighborhood, as Shama said. Help the community, as Kailash mentioned. Anything that you would like to do. And I would like Dr. Nirmala to say a few words for the parents, because that's also very important, along with the youth. She has spoken about the parents and about the student, but I think the parent perspective, Dr. Nirmala, I would like you to give a few words. You have been guiding parents since years, and you have been doing it right now in the COVID period also, very aggressively. Can you please say a few words on that?
Okay, sure. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So first, I would like the parents to validate the feelings of the teenager. So a teenager at home may be getting very frustrated, and the parent will get angry and say, grumbling about? I think they need to understand and they need to turn around to the teenager and say, I can understand how frustrated you feel because you can't go out and hang out with your friends. So that's one thing. Secondly, I feel teenagers are complaining to me that the parents are nagging them. Okay, so this is a little caution for parents. Surely you can request your children to help out in household chores, but the more you nag them, the more you command them, the more you order them, the more resistant they are. So definitely ask their help, seek their help, but be a little respectful. The third thing is that parents feel that now that the children are at home, I have to micromanage their life. Please don't do that. Let your children choose what activities they want to pursue. Let them plan their day. If they need your assistance, they will come to you. Another thing that I've noticed is that some parents at least are very strict about the use of social media. I would say, yes, limits are required, but please loosen the rules regarding social media because these teens have to compensate for the loss of socializing time due to the close down of schools and colleges. Another request to parents, please don't intrude on the privacy of your children. Now that they are at home, you may feel, oh, this is a wonderful opportunity to eavesdrop or just to pry into their phone or just to peep into their laptop. Please refrain from doing so because it does not communicate respect to the child. Two more things that come to my mind is they're from a totally different generation. So please respect that. See, we as older people, probably we like routine. We like consistency. We like stability. We like organization. They like novelty. They like risk. They like adventure. And let us respect them for what they are rather than, you know, each generation condemning and judging each other. And probably the last point I would like to give parents is, please set an example for your children. You want your children to help out in household chores, then husband and wife should help each other in household chores themselves. And that will set an example. Another major point which I want to bring up is that if you want your teens to understand that aggression is not the solution to the problem, then when you have a difference of opinion with your spouse, you need to contain it. You need to control it. You need to handle it with discipline and maturity. If you allow it to escalate and if you start screaming and fighting and shouting at each other, and if you draw your child into it, then it becomes a negative situation. And many students have told me that they get very traumatized by the fighting of their parents. So this is a request to parents to set a good example to your children. Yes, thank you.
Thank you, Nirmala. I would also like to focus on one more point, which is very important, which several questions have come for. This is for students who have been aspiring for international education and students who have got admission in certain good universities, whose aspirations have no boundaries, who were preparing to go. They almost had everything set. I would just like to get you all prepared that right now the international universities, most of them are going on to online education. This semester will end with online education. The next semester, which will start in August or September, may be also online, or it could be offline depending on the situation in that particular state or that particular country. But there is no assurance on that. No university is announcing whether they'll be offline or online. Of course, admissions are still on. It's your decision, but the experience of an offline classroom in an international, in a foreign country is going to be different. If you're going to go there and do an online course, it's rather better you search some online courses here and see what best you can do. However, the decision is yours. These are the realities. Pandemic will take its time to settle down. August, September, you can definitely be assured that you have enough time till then. Plan your life based on that. Plan your career, plan your education, plan your skills, plan your social work, plan your family based on all this. Is there any panelist who would like to add any words? Anything that I have missed or you have missed and you would like to add? One more thing that I would like to say is that this program which is being conducted by Matushri Manibai Shivji Devji Kanya Kedoni Fund in association and support from 39 Solutions, is going to come back with another stream of speakers, and the same speakers also will be repeated. You can put in your suggestions in the chat. You can give your suggestions for topics or for areas that you would like to cover, to be covered, because we are going to have certain generic sessions and certain specific sessions, very, very micro. Because today there have been so many points that have been made by the speakers, and I'm sure you want to hear them more in depth. You want to hear about their stories also more in depth. And it is not justified if we just do this generic view and move out, but we will definitely come back with more specific points and specific sessions. But if you have any suggestions, do give them. Before we wind up, Bashesh, would you like to say something? You had a hand raised for it.
Yeah, there are a lot of questions and requests on YouTube. So I just take 1 minute to answer. कि एजुकेशन सिर्फ डिग्री से नहीं मिलता है, एजुकेशन काम करने से मिलता है. तो ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है कि आप लिंक्डइन पे जाइए, ट्विटर पे जाइए, और बहुत सारे कंपनीज आपको अब वर्चुअल इंटर्नशिप भी दे रहे हैं, एंड दैट इज द बेस्ट वे टू लर्न. आप सुशील जी के साथ काम कर सकते हैं, सौरभ जी के साथ, कैलाश, मी, यू कैन वर्क. वी हैव गॉट मोर देन लॉट्स ऑफ ओपनिंग्स हमारे बीच में और लिंक्डइन पे और अदर भी बाकी ओपनिंग्स है. तो अपने फील्ड में भी अग्रेसिव. जो इंसान घर पे बैठेगा और कंफर्ट में रहेगा वो पेरेंट या स्टूडेंट को कुछ नहीं मिलेगा. ढूंढने से भगवान भी मिलता है, तो एक्सपीरियंस क्यों नहीं मिलेगा. तो बी अग्रेसिव, आस्क फॉर हेल्प एंड यू विल रिसीव हेल्प. सो माय लास्ट सजेशन इज वर्क, एंड सेकंड इज काफी केस स्टडीज है. देयर इज अ बार्बर रमेश बाबू जो रोल्स रॉयस चलाता है. देयर इज अ लुंगी में जो डोसा बनाता था इंसान, प्रेम गणपति. टुडे हिज टर्नओवर इज 30 crores, द ओनर ऑफ डोसा प्लाजा. So education is not just a degree, it is the learning attitude, it is the hunger, it is the passion. So jitna aap roz sikhoge, roz discuss karoge, and be active on LinkedIn especially, you will get a lot of guidance, lot of mentorship, and my best suggestion is work. Jo clarity, passion aur jo experience work karne se milta hai, wo discussion se, reading se nahi milta. So please work, work and volunteer. That is the last comments from my side.
I would just like to add one point over here. Since I asked you all to add what you have done during the pandemic, I would just like to give one example of what I have done. I don't think it would be justified if I don't say that also. Amongst the multiple cores of the family and the home, the one thing that I felt very satisfied is that I have, you can say, ideated and designed basically a learning management system. Although I'm not a technological person, I worked with technological people to help support that. And that learning management system is fully free. It has proved to be a great asset to educational institutions. There are hundreds of colleges today who are under training for this particular learning management system, which is a very, very simple system. It will be useful for all teachers or anybody who wants to conduct any classes, sessions, courses, not only now, even in future. So I would really like to introduce to you in future that particular learning management system, which is freely available during this pandemic period when hundreds and thousands of teachers in various universities, various schools want to reach out to their students through a, you know, live platform, and where they can have all their learning material on it. I really enjoyed it. It was a very creative experience. And this is just to share that everybody has something to give if one wants to. So the will has to be within us. I know of many, many young students who have been supporting the older people in fetching errands for them, in fetching things for them. There have been people who have been able to supply food to millions of people. So there are youth who are involved. If any one of you want to know how to get connected, please contact us, put a chat, your details on this chat, and we will contact you back. If you do not know what to do, we will have you to do something for this world, for this nation, for this society. Thank you very much. I would like to thank all the panel members on behalf of the KVO Sthanakwasi Mahajan, Sanchalit Matushri Manibai Shivji Devji, Kanya Kedoni Fund, and 39 Solutions. You all have been really amazing in the very, very brief time that each one of y'all had, I think y'all have all made it very well. Bashesh, I would like you to also have a final word. As a partner organizer, you can also have the final word.
I am, it's my pleasure and privilege to help, to guide and to serve. So thank you, Dr. Dedia. Thank you, Matu Shri Manibai, KVO. And thank you, panelists. And we are here. All of us are here with the bhavana to help and serve. So we'll keep doing that again. Please stay safe, stay kind. Thank you so much.
Yeah, all of you all, please stay safe. And again, my last words again to the entire medical committee, the community who have been out of the happiness and the joy that we are experiencing, who are under the stress and the, you can say the pain, the physical and the mental trauma, who are taking the entire responsibility of the people around us. I really thank them from the bottom of my heart and each and everyone who is connected and serving the nation at this time. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.